Hello everyone, welcome to Maheshwari's Majestic Learning. It's a place for smart learning. Today we are going to explore about Scilab. It's an open source tool and alternative for MATLAB and Octave. Scilab is freely downloadable numerical computation software for engineering and scientific application. Scilab is similar to MATLAB, but it requires less disk space than MATLAB and Octave. Scilab includes a translator called MATLAB to Scilab translator, that is, .m files generated in the MATLAB could be translated to .scilab files, .sei files. And Scilab also dynamically compile or link other languages such as C, Java, etc. Scilab supports integrated object-oriented 2D, 3D graphics with animation. And this Scilab is available in three operating systems, Windows, Linux, and Mac OS. To download the latest version of the installer of Scilab, just go to www.scilab.org or scilab.in/download-scilab. Once the installation is over, to get started with Scilab, double click the Scilab 6.1.0. So this is the latest Scilab what I have it in my laptop. So double click it, which is available in the desktop. So if the other way to do to open your Scilab is go to program Scilab 6.1.0 and then select the appropriate version. After completing your job, if you like to quit your Scilab program, you can end it by clicking the file quit option, else you can type quit in the Scilab console window. The other shortcut is you can press Ctrl plus Q to quit your Scilab program. So once you open the Scilab workshop, you could see two default workspaces. One is a console for calculation. Next one is the editor for writing the programs. If you like to visualize some graphical windows, you could get this graphical window for displaying the graphics, and you have an embedded help browser window to display the help. Scilab is a case sensitive. So here capital A is not equal to small a. So whatever you type it in capital A, uppercase will not be equivalent to the lowercase. One important point with respect to Scilab is Scilab is a matrix-based orientation concept. It supports matrix-based orientation concept. So this is a console of the Scilab. It will be having menu bar, toolbar, and the command prompt. So I'll just show you the console of the Scilab. So here, as I said, Scilab is case sensitive. So if you want to visualize the graph, I'm just typing BAR followed by the input parameters. So if I give it, I could get a graph window. This is the graph window. So same thing, you could do it, you could test with the console window. If I type capital BAR followed by the parameter, it will throw an error because in Scilab, capital uppercase letters is not equivalent to small case lowercase letter. So it is a case sensitive. So if you want to visualize your embedded help window, you could click a Scilab help question mark in the menu bar. Then you could see the list of commands or the help menu which is going to be supported for the Scilab. So as I discussed, help browser could be visualized by clicking the question mark icon in the toolbar. Then you can type help browser in the command window to get the help browser. then the shortcut key to get the functionalities of the predefined functions could be done by pressing the tab. So if you like to get the factorial, if you type FAT and if you use your tab window, the list of functions supported using this variables FACT will be displayed. So this is the another shortcut. So now I'm going to explore about how this Scilab console is going to work as a calculator. One important point here is, if no variables is assigned as the output variable in the console of Scilab, by default it will take the output and store the output in ANS, ANS variable. I'm just repeating it. If you're not specifying any variables to your expression, if you're not defining any variables to your expression, then by default the output will be stored in ANS output variable. If you like to separate your expressions with multiple expressions, then separation will happen by giving the comma. So then this Scilab will support all the basic arithmetic operations: addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, power. Power could be done using two ways, using cap symbol and the double hashed symbol, and transpose conjugate will happen with a dash symbol. One important point you should remember, if you like to give a command in your Scilab, kindly use double slash. So whatever the content or the text in the double slash is considered to be the command of the program. So that line will not be executed for its output. So the system will ignore it, considering that is a command. So practice problem, you could type this: 27 cap of 1 divided by 3 plus 3 into 3 to the power of 2 minus 1. So I just have just brought all the basic arithmetic operations in a single expression. So since I doesn't have any variable assigned to it, all the values will be stored in the output variable called ANS. So if you want to specify the command, then you can use your double slash to comment your answer. This is practice one. So before we start with processing, it's a good practice and habit that we have to clear your console. So our CLC clear screen will help us to clear the output displayed in the console. The shortcut to clear your console is F2. So if you press F2, the shortcut key, it also clears the console. If you want to clear the variables, so if you want to kill the variables, then you can use clear, C-L-E-A-R. If you want to clear your figure window, you just use C-L-F. So diary command will help us to list all the current session comments. So these are the predefined variables existing in the Scilab. If you like to use about the imaginary unit of I, then you have to specify percentage I. For pi, percentage pi. For exponent, it is percentage e. For epsilon, it is percentage eps. For infinity, it is percentage inf. If you want to define not a number, then you have to specify percentage nan. Percentage s and percentage z are defined for polynomial variables. And when to work with Boolean variables, we'll be using percentage t for true and percentage f for false. So the practice problem is percentage I, when just specify percentage I, the output you could visualize with 0 dot, that is your real part, plus I. I is your imaginary part. So percentage pi for your displaying your pi value, 3.1415927. And if you want to explore about your exponent value, percentage e. Epsilon is percentage eps, and percentage s and z is for your polynomial variable, and inf for the infinity, nan for not a number, and t, percentage t and percentage f is returning true and false of the Boolean variables. So challenging task one, I'm just giving here a small word problem. So there were 42 mangoes in each carriage. 12 such carrots of mangoes were delivered to a factory. So 4 mangoes are rotten and it has to be thrown away. So the question is, we have to identify the number of mangoes which has been packed. Okay, so to explore it, the solution will be 12 into 42 will be getting 504. So total number of mangoes delivered was 504. The number of remaining mangoes is 504 minus 4, because 4 rotten mangoes has been thrown out. So subtraction has come here, and in order to divide the mangoes in of 10 of each box, I'm going to divide it by 10. So multiplication, subtraction and division is going to be put together in a single expression. You could get the output as 50 boxes of mango. So you can try this word problem implementing inside your SciLab. So basic mathematical functions in SciLab. So we have a general functions, predefined functions. If you want to use a calculate the square root, the function is sqrt of x. Exponential is exp of x. Natural logarithmic is log of x. Decimal logarithmic is log of 10 of x. Absolute value abs x. Factorial of x could be identified by the function called factorial x. So practice problem, you can type sqrt of 9. So you could get the answer as 3. Factorial of 5, you will get an answer as 3 on 20. So here output variables has not been defined, so by default it will take and display it in the variable called ANS. So dear learners, our next learning will be with statistical function and creating arrays, and this will happen in our next video. Thank you so much for watching us. Kindly subscribe us, share, give share, like and comment. Thank you so much from Majestic Learning.